did advertising happen to you? We know you're a sorted guy. You started pretty early. Like in school, you did some experiment with filmmaking. And then immediately after graduation, you started doing ad films with Pradeep Sarkar. And you set up your Chrome Pictures also pretty early in your career because you yourself are very, very young even now. So how, what did attract you to advertising filmmaking?
So this is a long story. My father always used to think that, you know, what will he do in his life? Kya karega? What will he do? And because I was okay in studies, so, you know, I wanted to be a cricketer. And then I left because of whatever reason. And then one day my mother asked me that, tu acting karega? Modeling karega? I was in class 11 at that time. And that moment I decided that my hero will be. So that's how my journey started. I started meeting people in Delhi. And as I started meeting people, that's how I met Pradeep Da. He used to be in Delhi at that time, Pradeep Sarkar. So I was in class 11 when I did my first ad film with him as an actor. वहां पे मेरा दिमाग खराब हो गया उनको देख कर कि ये जो कर रहे हैं वो मेन चीज है. व्हाट एम आई डूइंग? So I don't know from where this thing came up. Maybe I was at that time, at that age, you know, you don't think so deep. You think very, you know, A, B, C, D, आप उतना ही सोचते हैं. तो मैंने उनको वहां पे बोला that I told him that, you know, I want to work with you. In my mind, there were only two things. One, if I work with him, I will write in front of him all the time. Right. So I can get acting chances as many times I can. Okay.
Right.
To this man travels a lot.
Yeah.
So I'll get to travel a lot.
Correct.
So these are the two things. The reason I told him, I want to work with you. My school result had not come, like 12th class result. It comes in September 15th. And on 8th September, I joined him.
That was which year?
I think it was 99 or 98. So worked with him for about 6 years.
That's right.
While working over there, my partner Alia, we used to work together. I used to do production and I used to do post-production. I used to be AD. For about 3 years, I did not know that whether I'm an AD or not. So there were no defined line to, you know, this is what your job is, because I was doing everything from pre to post to the shoot to everything. So that was a plus point.
Yeah.
She told me that, you know, yeah, I see a creative streak in you. I think you can be a director. At that time, I decided, arey haan, main director ban sakta hun.
Correct.
So I decided that I'll be a director. So at the age 24, we started Chrome Pictures, me, Alia, and Hemant,
right.
Three partners.
Right.
So that's the whole journey.
उसके बाद आप लोग 1000 फिल्म बना लिए. Almost 1000 films you guys have directed as a part of Chrome. Almost.
Sir, I think I have directed around 2000 ad films.
2000.
Around 2000 ad films. Just me.
My God. I have had the tough task of, I've chosen just 3 of that illustrious career of yours of having done 2000 ad films. And you can possibly guess the ones I will ask you to talk about. The first one, obviously, is the one which won you the Silver Can Lion, which is the Silent Anthem. What I want you to do is to just tell us some highlights, challenges, fun moments, and satisfaction of creating these campaigns. So let's start with the Silent Anthem.
I'd gone to Mudra to meet Bobby Pawar. After the ad film was discussed, I was getting out and he said, you know, I have one idea. Would you want to hear it? I said, yeah. And he said, Silent National Anthem. Deaf kids, they are singing National Anthem with sign language. I said, man, this is outstanding. I said, you leave this ad film on the side. I don't want to make that. I will make this. So, then that the process started because I said, you know, I want to see it like this. I want to shoot it in this way and all those things. So Bobby is an amazing creative person. And he said, it's yours. You do the way you want to. And then I wanted to shoot with real deaf kids, you know, mute kids. So we started finding out the number of schools we have in and around Bombay. So we first of all, we contacted somebody who knows the sign language, right. You know, who knows the sign language, national anthem, how national anthem would be sung by sign language.
Correct.
So we found that person. And then from with her help, and it was a Sunday when we were shooting, and I had said that, you know, tell all these kids to come in their own school dresses. 500 kids came, all 500 kids came in those buses, and I shot that film for a day with them. What I realized over there was that we say that, you know, these are special kids. They're actually special kids. Special means not in a negative way, in a positive way. Just before 3 months, uske 3 mahine pehle, I was shooting one more commercial with kids in the same school.
Okay.
In Don Bosco, Bombay.
Okay.
It was a nightmare for me to shoot with 200, 300 kids over there. The normal
Correct.
Kids.
Correct.
You know? Like you tell them, you're announcing, they don't want to listen to you.
Yeah.
Mummy, dhoop lag rahi hai, mummy, garmi lag rahi hai, bhook lagi hai, wo sab cheezein chal rahi hai. But these kids, intelligent, and you know, they would listen to you. Their teachers would just do one ishara to them, go stand in one line. They would all go stand in one line. Okay, stand up. They would all stand up. Okay, sit down over there. Dhoop thi, matlab it was a sunny day, but none of the kids said that we can't. It's too hot. We cannot. So. And then I saw there were 4 or 5 kids while I was setting my shot. They are laughing. They're just laughing because they're cracking jokes in sign language. I said, "Oh man!"
Right.
So while I was shooting, I was like very normal. Okay, fine. This is how God has made them.
Correct.
And so I unke saath mein kuch extra unko. सहानुभूति नहीं देना चाहता राधर आई वॉज लर्निंग फ्रॉम देम सो आई वॉज वेरी नॉर्मल विद देम लाइक इफ यू सी दैट शॉट वेयर द किड डज दिस एंड वन किड जस्ट कम्स एंड टर्न्स हिज हैंड आई हैव नॉट डिजाइंड दैट शॉट द किड वाज स्टैंडिंग बिहाइंड ही डिड इट ऑन हिज ओन दे आर सो इंटेलिजेंट एंड दे आर क्रैकिंग जोक्स एंड आई वॉज लाइक ओह दिस इज सो अमेजिंग दे आर लाफिंग दे हैव देयर ओन लैंग्वेज दे हैव देयर ओन वर्ल्ड You know, we are all in the same world, but they are just outstanding. And then when I said pack up, we had got gifts for everybody, for all the kids. So I said before all the kids go, we want the gifts should be given to them. So once they received the gifts, they got to know that, you know, the shoot is over. You will not believe I was standing at one place. I was talking to somebody and I was surrounded by 500 kids. They just wanted to touch my hand and go. They just wanted to say bye to me. They just wanted to say shake hand with me. So I was surrounded by 500 kids. That when I felt that, I had tears in my eyes. The whole day I was normal. The whole day I was like, okay, fine. Let's shoot.
Yeah.
But when this moment happened, I had tears in my eyes. I said, this is like amazing.
So the second film I talk about, Vanyu, a goal in Spikes Asia, you can obviously understand the one I'm talking about is Help a Child Reach 5. And some highlights and fun moments and satisfaction of creating this amazing ad film for Lifebuoy.
So Lifebuoy has won Cannes also. Yeah. So the script was written by the idea is of Mr. Amir Jaleel and Sagar Kapoor from Lolitas, Malayalam Lolitas. Yes. When they narrated this idea to me, I said, okay, fine. There are so many superstitions in India.
That's
one of the superstition is people walk on their hands also.
Right.
So the biggest challenge to make that film was to do the casting. You know, to do the right casting for this film. So one thing I just told them that, you know, I think we should be open about the location, like, you know, where it should be shot.
Right.
It will depend on where we get a person.
But it also talks about a very, very genuine problem of, you know, yes. how a child, we just don't understand these things sitting in a metro city, that, you know, how children in the smallest of villages across India often don't even have the privilege of having a fifth birthday.
Because we usko mante hain apne dimag ke andar. We decide that, you know, if we do this, this will happen. The right. whole idea was about that. That, you know, if I do this, my son has turned 5. Now, maine wo mannat mangi thi, toh mein ko wo puri karni hai. So I was just telling the shooting process of that, and the bigger idea in that whole thing is that, like you said, in villages there are kids who doesn't even reach 5 years of age. So and what is the reason? Reason is hygiene, washing hands, and, you know, diarrhea simar jaate hain bacche, because there is no cleanliness. It's not followed. So super amazing idea for a super amazing client. I would say that they chose the Lifebuoy took the script. That was also a very, very big achievement, you know.
Right.
So then we said, okay, fine. We started looking for the cast, and the actor who has worked in the film, he is not an actor.
Okay.
He's actually a kabaddi. In Chennai.
Okay.
जो scrap का सामान खरीदते हैं और फिर वो बेचते हैं आगे. He just knew how to walk on the hands. So I said, okay, fine, it's not enough. I need one more guy who walks, who has the same body type, because I need a body double also. Okay. Because I did not want to use harness or strings or anything
correct.
Like that.
Correct.
Or do anything in post, because it has to be real, you know.
Correct.
So we found this guy, and then we found the other guy also in Madurai somewhere. We found the other person, and I said, okay, fine, chalo, let's start shooting. And we went to shoot in Madurai. After 1.5 days of shoot, both these guys, their shoulders gave up. Though we had the physio and everybody on set, their shoulders gave up. They said they will not be able to do it.
Okay.
So I said, now what to do? I don't want to use the harness. Then I asked the doctor, I said, what do you think of when can we shoot? He said, you will have to give them a rest of 1 month. Okay. So that commercial is actually shot in 3 months. It took us 3 months to complete that commercial. So we gave them the rest. So Amir, I spoke to Amir. Amir said, no, it will be very inhuman to shoot with them, like the way they are right now. We'll not be able to shoot. I said, we'll not be able to shoot. So we'll have to give them a 1 month thing, break. After 1 month, we started shooting in Hampi.
Okay.
Because we did not get permissions to shoot it in Madurai.
Okay.
So we went to Hampi to shoot. One day of shoot just happened, and cyclone came in Chennai, and it hit Hampi. So we had to again. It was raining for 2 days continuously, so we couldn't shoot. We had to again pack up. And then after some 15-20 days, I came back again. So my production and everybody was saying that, you know, you have enough footage.
Yeah.
You can edit the film. What you have, what you have shot.
Correct.
You can edit the film with this.
Right.
I said, no. The main thing was that Makode wala scene, where leaves that Makoda.
Yeah.
So the insight in that was that he is going to, you know, for his kid's life, he can't take another life.
Correct.
While going over there.
Correct.
So I wanted to shoot that. I wanted to shoot some shots in the village.
Right.
So it took us 3 months to finish that commercial, and then it was edited and presented to the client.
And the third film I want to talk about, which even Vidya Balan, who was on this show before, spoke about as one of our favorite films, is the Google Reunion film. Which was obviously one of those long format, 2 minute, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
3.5 minutes.
Where these two childhood friends from India and Pakistan who get separated during partition, and, you know, kind of what's the reunion all about. So talk a bit about what happened with the film?
So, when I got the script, I read the script. So, Sukesh, ONM, Sukesh Naik, he is a very dear friend of mine. And that was the first time we were working together. That was the first film we worked together on. So, he told me the idea. And then, you know, what happened? I used to hear a lot of stories from my own grandmother about the partition, about her own friends in Pakistan. So, in my mind, I had those stories,
right?
You know, and those stories were very clear in my head. Right. So, me and Sukesh, we started discussing the whole thing. And what happened is that when the script came, I said, "When do you want to make, as in release the film?" They said, 14th of January. At in the night, about 11:59, they wanted to put it on
right.
Google Medium.
Right.
So I said, I will not be good. Because they said, why? I said, because I'm busy right now and this film needs enough time, you know, a lot of, like, I need my mind space.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's a beautiful story, beautiful script. I don't want to just make it. Like मैं उसको उस तरह से मैं justify नहीं कर पाऊंगा. So let's make this when Amit is free. That was, I was so glad and I was so happy that they waited for me. I was so happy because I really really wanted to make this film. So then we started to cast the film. Casting was very very important. So we found these two men who are 85 years at that time, 85 right. years old.
Right.
And when I reached on set, I got to know that they are old friends.
Right.
They are connected from theater time, you know.
Yeah.
वो अभी भी theater करते थे, कभी कुछ साल पहले तक theater साथ में करते थे. Satyu sir and Badola sir. It's an emotional story. It's an emotional film. But the fun part is that I was laughing throughout the film.
Okay.
Through and through the film, I was laughing. What was happening on set was out. Standing. So, Satyu sir ke dialogues nahi the because unka ek hi dialogue tha, the Pakistani dadu, jinhone Pakistani dadu ka role kiya, ki happy birthday yara. And Badola sir ke kaafi sare dialogues the, jo basically he was playing the Indian dadu. So somewhere some ego thing was happening between them that I have dialogue and you don't have dialogue. So one of the shot I remember, I was in one corner with my video assist and they were over there on the side, and Badola sir is giving his expressions and his dialogues, and Satyu sir is not reacting. He's just not reacting. So first take happened, second take happened, third take happened. He's not reacting because between actors, you know, this happens sometime to spoil the other actor's performance. This happens, okay? So, so I was understanding what is happening over there. And on the fourth day, Badola sir started, "Oh, tu react kyun nahi karta yaar? He's not reacting. Amit, he said, wo react nahi kar raha." So I went to Satyu sir. I said, "Sir, Satyu sir, please, you have to react on this." He said, "Oh, okay, okay, take one more." So then he reacted and gave the shot. Now I'm taking the over shoulder shot of Satyu sir, and now I'm shooting
Badola
sir. And no, now I'm shooting Satyu sir from Badola sir's point of view.
Yeah.
Over shoulder. So this time I went to Badola sir. I said, "Sir, when he will say happy birthday yara no, and he'll hug you, aap immediately hug mat karna, 2 second ke baad hug karna. और जरा जोर से हक करना क्योंकि आपका दोस्त है बचपन का 14 साल अब के थे आप सब साथ में नाउ यू आर 85 इयर्स ओल्ड ऑलमोस्ट 75 इयर्स 75 70 इयर्स हैव गॉन एंड ही स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू सो यू वुड नॉट ही इज नॉट यंग एनी मोर ही इज ओल्ड ही सेड ओके लैला ही सेड लैला ही इज अ पंजाबी मैन ही सेड लैला सो The shot started and Satyu sir hugged him and Badola sir hugged him tight. And he did. And Satyu sir is saying, "Are meri kamar, are meri kamar." एंड I ran, I said, what happened, sir? He said, ये बहुत जोर के मेरे को टाइट जफी पा रहा है, इसको बोलो ऐसे नहीं करे. So I went to Satyu sir, I said, Satyu sir, I went to Badola sir, I said, Badola sir, he said, अब ले ले तू shot.
Yeah.
They were like kids. And that was the main thing, that, you know, they had very less time together. When they came together, oh man, it was a riot. It was a riot on set. They are so amazing. Like the song in the film, it was added later. So all those things.